Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Power Racing Series and Maker Faire. This is the Power Racing Series. If you guys don't know, what we do is we take Power Wheels. Let's ride on kids' toys, buy kids. They race them around the neighborhood for a year or two. Then they grow out of them. And then you put them up on Craigslist, or worse, you throw them out. Well, we take them off your hands, and we turn them into lean, mean racing machines. Something bigger, so much better, stronger than before. We turn kids' cars into race cars. Because all the people here participating are merely just kids at heart. These are all engineers, students, artists who frankly don't know any better. And they do it for less than $500. That's right, for the price of a new Power Wheel. You can take an old one and turn it into a real race car. All these cars are limited to just 48 volts. $500. They have a fuse limiting them to just 2 horsepower. And they race around our tracks. We started our season last month in San Francisco and have been slowly working our way across the country. We're here now, we're gonna be moving on to Detroit, New York, Nashville, Milwaukee. We got races going on in Atlanta and Orlando as well. All these cars race for points for the national championship. That's all they do it for. They do it for imaginary points. We're gonna have some great racing for you today. This is going to be a sprint race. I don't know if you guys missed it, but we had a 30-lap race, had a couple cars break down. Notably, the ones up front, the ones who qualified farthest up, who were some of the fastest, unfortunately had some mechanical issues. They break down. 30 laps was too much for them. So we said, how about 40 laps? Let's see how well they do with 40-lap sprint. See how well some of these cars do. They're gonna be racing around the track as fast as possible for 40 laps. They're gonna be racing around, and we're gonna be racing for your heart. And what do I mean by that? Moxie points. Where is that moxie board? Hey, moxie board guy.
Where is that moxie board? Right over there.
Board. Way over there, there's a board. Every single car has a button, and every single button press turns into race points, and all those race points go towards that national championship. Which means our champion can be a car that's not fast, but awesome. And that's what we like at the Power Racing Series, because I'm gonna tell you right now, the leader for the weekend is not the cars up front here. It is, in fact, cars a little bit farther back. Waffle Card is leading in points right now.
208 points.
She's fast and awesome.
Current.
And right behind her, just 5 tiny little points. Just 5 little points, 5 little button presses. It's all it takes is for the Wienermobile right here to surpass all the way back there in midfield. Got a lot of Wiener folks out here.
That's right, Patrick. Joker, which is your pole sitter, is third currently for this weekend points. Lilo and Stitch is in fourth with 104 points. And Fubar Labs all the way from New Jersey, that poop emoji, is looking for as much moxie because right now they have 96 points and they haven't had the best weekend yet.
No.
They've been slowly improving.
We've got great teams from around the country have come here. We've got teams from here from Fort Wayne, Indiana, New Jersey, Chicago, Pittsburgh. We also have some hometown heroes. Omaha is kind of close, but we also have from Cowtown Computer Congress, Kansas City. We have Duct Tape and Zip Ties and the Ford F-150, your two hometown heroes back here. These guys are going to need some of that moxie points I'm talking about.
So
hopefully they can push their theoretical position from way back there to way up here. 40 lap sprint we're gonna do. I want a clean race because if there's a dirty racing, of which you may have seen in the last race, they get grim penalties. They have to answer to our grim. They get pulled to the infield and have to perform some sort of penance for their race sins before they're allowed to continue to race. 40 lap sprint racing for the Power Racing Series here.
All right, while Patrick gets back into timing and scoring, I want to make sure, give a round of applause for all of our track marshals out there. Track marshals, they're putting themselves out for risk. They are minding their ankles because that is first on the front line on these cars. They have to be very careful when these cars get all wired up together. They have to pull them apart, and they're helping out. They're volunteers. They're from the teams. They work together to keep the race underway. More importantly, drivers, are you ready? Got a lot of thumbs up. Transponders are transponding. And most importantly, fans, are you ready to race? All right, so before we get underway, once Patrick gives the thumbs up, we're going to have a parade lap to have the timing and scoring bridge. Patrick, when that's good to go. All right, so give one last wave to the crowd. The parade lap. Give it up, round of applause for them. They're going on their way for you. As we always say here, these cars will not be in this condition by 40 laps from now. They will be torn to pieces. Clearing something from the track that fell off. How necessary is that part that came off there? This is why we do a startup lap.
Yeah, the Wienermobile unfortunately has a vote Wiener sign that is over our height limit of 6 feet. We need to take it down.
Oh. Did you just harm your Sarah car doing that? Oh wait, no, they're just trying to pull it off.
There you go.
Now they're gonna need your Moxie votes to recover from that.
The grid has agreed to fix their wiener.
But now their stair car is all stared out.
It is, it's a little busted.
Oh, they looks like they got it back attached. Unfortunately, that would take out our timing and scoring.
It did. It was over the 6 foot height limit.
Yes.
And some people feel like pushing it.
All right. Now that everything's back in order. Oh, that's a good spot for it. All right, Patrick, I'm turning it over to you.
All righty. I'm going to need everyone's help counting down here.
All right.
Drivers, prepare to race. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
4, 3, 2, 1. Victory flag, Power Racing out of turn one. The Joker having a strong pull away into the lead. Second place, Car of 1000 faces third place, Fluor Labs, looking very similar to the start of the last race. 1, 2, 3 right there. Excellent pace by the top three cars, but Waffle Car does not waffle in behind. They're making an excellent move through the lap traffic. That top four is keeping it together. PS1, that second place car right there, getting kind of close to the leader, while Fumar's also constricting. Ladies and gentlemen, your top three are really close.
It's Joker, Card of 1000 Faces.
Oh, Fumar on the outside!
Moved up to second there.
Second place for Fumar Labs. That poop emoji. Sliding its way to second.
The Waffle Cart blowing their horn as they go around the track. War Rig doing a good job holding on to fifth.
Yeah, fifth place, but no, I spoke too soon. Lilo.
Lilo and Stitch taking it.
Oh, and there's a slowdown. Yeah, the Magic School Bus. Yeah, you're right, Patrick. Magic School Bus definitely jumped the War Rig and the Wienermobile. Your winner from the last race. Much slower this race.
I know, he's back in ninth place, that wiener.
Oh yeah, on the outside, there goes the leaders there. Fumar Labs now stuck behind a wiener. Oh, the hamburger definitely overcooked itself.
Oh no.
That poor burger.
The poor burger. You guys are gonna have to push it off the grid.
Yeah,
get it off the track, guys.
Get that burger off the track. How unfortunate for Rapid Charge.
That is unfortunate for them.
We're still under caution until they can get it off the track.
Yeah, because it's right there on the corner.
It's right on the racing line, unfortunately.
A little dangerous. Alrighty.
Alright, this time, green flag. That's bunched up the leaders, first and second now.
It did.
The Joker and Fubar now are right next to each other.
It's going to be a tight, tight race between those two.
Yes, that's right, Patrick. One and two. They're kind of pulling away from third place PS1 in the waffle cart. And meanwhile, the Magic School Press getting ahead of the waffle cart.
That's right.
That's for position.
Card of a Thousand Faces holding on.
Yeah, but it looks like
third place.
That school bus is going to close that gap.
It is. Oh, no, waffle cart takes it back.
Waffle cart back ahead. Waffle cart holding on to her position. Oh, the chain hop!
Off the chain! It's Rizzo racing!
It's the leader! The leader's hopped the chain and Fubar lapses into the lead!
Oh, no!
Yet another problem for Rizzo racing,
who abused last time, now throws a chain.
And Patrick Fubar's quite far ahead of Car of a Thousand Faces from PS1.
Car of a Thousand Faces.
The waffle cart is now catching.
Yes.
Owen, a big
the Wienermobile goes wide.
Really wide, it tossed the driver.
Oh man.
I don't even know what happened.
All right, we're okay now. That poor Wienermobile, unfortunately.
Patrick, it's still kind of backed up. The burger apparently joining the Wiener in the wall.
Oh. They're good, they're moving underway. But then, unfortunately, that incident, the Wienermobiles moved back down to fifth place.
Oh, how unfortunate.
Part of a Thousand Faces and Lilo and Stitch passed him while he was unfortunately stuck in the wall.
Yes. So, Patrick, that puts second place down.
Second place is Card of a Thousand Faces, Waffle Cart in third, Lilo Stitch fourth, Wienermobile in fifth.
Right now, PS1's Card of a Thousand Faces in clean air. Nobody in front or behind them. A waffle cart trying to make their way through traffic. And making her way. Oh, and she took off Miss Frizzle's bus. A collision there.
They then lost the front end to their car.
Oh, and Lilo and Stitch is off to the side.
Lilo and Stitch, unfortunately, stuck in the wall. They don't have reverse.
The front end of the Magic School Bus.
The front end of the Magic School Bus is completely destroyed.
Destroyed. Now. Oh, the magic's gone, Patrick. It's just gone. I just don't know what to think about that. The statement that makes. Well, breakfast is better than education, apparently. The weird lessons we learn on the racetrack. Oh, the leader having to get hard on the brakes as the blue family car holds him up.
He's holding his wiener time.
Patrick, that shakes up the field quite a bit because waffle cart was up to third. Lilo Stitch had to fall down from that collision into the wall on the outside of turn one. That put her down to fourth. That's a large clawback that they're going to have to do on that. They definitely lost time for hitting the wall, but Wienermobile is still in fifth. That collision really set them back. Collision or she was thrown from the wiener? I'm not sure what happened. I didn't catch it.
The poor Joker coming back out now. Still, unfortunately, 8 laps down trying to get that chain back on.
Patrick, with enough laps in the longer race,
yeah,
they should be able to claw back a few positions. That's your point.
But they're not going to be able to get back to the lead.
And they'll need your Moxie votes, too. Patrick, Fubar is staying out of trouble this race, and it's so far benefiting them. Their nearest competitors, one of them having a chain hop, the other one of them getting kind of close to the wall, had a little brush with it. That keeps Fubar Labs, that green poop emoji, out ahead. But Patrick, I've noticed something. I'm picking up a distinct smell from the field. I don't know if a motor is starting to expire, but I do sense that someone is pushing their car to the limit. Oh, and we have the Akira bike over.
Oh no! He tipped over on that bike of his.
He tipped over on his own, fortunately.
Looks like he's underway.
Back underway.
He's a little bit more cautious now, knowing that he can tip over.
The Akira bike is definitely a very interesting experiment. It's not necessarily built to win, it's built to prove a concept. And
It's a good proof of concept. Unfortunately, it's only netted them 7 laps so far.
Yes. Meanwhile, PS1's secondary car is in the pits now.
Oh no, the Bluesmobile.
The Bluesmobile.
Part of a Thousand Faces holding on to second.
Yes, but it looks like Fubar is far enough ahead to hold off anything unless something happens.
Yeah, he's got a whole lap on Part of a Thousand Faces.
That's right, Fubar's definitely coming back into contention. And with about 15 laps to go, Fubar is looking very good right now. This is where they've wanted to be. Keep in mind, they came so close to winning a title last year. They're less than 100 points away. And after a season worth of racing, you're talking about many, many points. So 100 points is not that much to lose by. Oh, and a little bit of rough racing between the Rizzo family.
It's an inter-family spat there between...
Yeah, a little bit of an argumentation
between
there.
Between the Joker and Lilo and Stitch. Oh no, Part of a Thousand Faces!
Oh no, the second place car! It's not underpowered!
He can't move!
No!
He's getting pushed back to the pits, unfortunately, and there goes Waffle Car!
Waffle Car now at the second place!
Oh no! Waffle Car taking second! Part of a Thousand Faces now dropping down to third. And now fourth. Oh, it's gonna be bad.
Oh no, yet again for PS1 on a big, they were in the lead last race. Oh no, the burger again in the wall. The burger really likes
burgers.
To eat walls. Which I don't think burgers are supposed to eat anything, but there they are.
It's a retake on Pink Floyd, another burger in the wall.
Oh, is that what they were writing?
Okay.
You're the worst, Patrick. You're absolutely the worst.
That poor
Are they
burger.
Back underway?
Can the burger get moving?
We got a race to finish here.
Come on, can you get moving? That burger is going to have to catch up.
Oh. He won't stop, ladies and gentlemen. He's just going to keep doing that. All right, back underway. Waffle Car now in second place. Fubar in first still. Meanwhile, the rest of the field is keeping interesting.
Part of a Thousand Faces came back out, was able to hold on to third.
Lilo and Stitch now at fourth place.
That caution from Berger helped out Part of a Thousand
Faces. Oh, and PS1 now, the other car, the Bluesmobile.
PS1, what's going on with their cars?
At the worst part of the track, too.
Getting pushed back to the pits again. Oh,
easily at
man.
The highest speed part of the course.
Back underway, only 8 laps to go now.
8 laps to go for Fubar
laps. 7
laps. Oh, the big hit! The magic school bus sideways. I'm not sure what happened there.
Was it Wiener related?
I don't know. There's too much food to count, Patrick. There's just too much of it.
You have burgers, waffles, and wieners.
Three wide!
6 laps to go now.
6 laps to go and 3 wide with Fubar Labs as your leader. That's some amazing movement there.
Waffle Cart holding on to second. Part of a Thousand Faces third, Lilo and Stitch fourth, the Wienermobile in fifth, the Magic School Bus in sixth, Joker moved himself up to seventh, the F-150 from CCC Casey's moved up to eighth.
Oh no, the Wiener's up! Oh.
The Wiener hard into that wall.
The Lilo and Stitch car, they kind of collided and the Wiener just slammed into the wall.
That's got too much mustard into those cars.
Yeah, it's way too much.